We believe that forest restoration is one of the most effective and immediately scalable solutions that we have for fighting climate change. And so our job is to accelerate that worldwide as much as possible.
We help projects all over the world to develop nurseries, to develop seed banks, and to have the software that they need to manage and to monitor their projects and to grow and establish healthy forests, which takes on average about 10 years. It starts with the seed, so you really take care of these seedlings that germinate, and then they go through this process of hardening or acclimatization, which is outside. They get used to the climate until they get to establishment or field-ready size. And a field-ready size then goes into the field and they're on their own. It's very important to mimic the native ecosystem when you plant trees because you're trying to create a self-sustaining system.
And because spacing in a lot of these areas, you know, can be like a meter and a half apart, high accuracy is really important to really ensure the long-term tracking and monitoring of these plants.
My name is Aka Rodriguez Herring. Born and raised on the Big Island, and we're using the Aero 100 Plus for marking out our trees, our plants, and then pretty much building one forest.
We chose the EOS Aero line of GPS receivers for many reasons. I can't emphasize enough the ease of it, of how it pairs with Esri's Field Maps app, where you have the mapping interface combined with the ability to collect data. Having that dual functionality, that is really powerful. And then the fact that you get this really high quality submeter accuracy.
You can see the species distribution by color, and it really helps with our planning. And we use these as a proving to show partners in the world how we do restoration.
One of the really important missing pieces to reforestation is accountability. And ideally you want full accountability, because then you can really track the data for science. You can know exactly how much carbon is being sequestered.
And now the GIS is becoming more and more accessible. It's really empowering individual projects to show impact assessment of what they're doing on the ground. This is very important for funding. Whether you're a nonprofit or a for-profit, if you have support coming, you need to show what you're doing. And it's very easy to do with a map.
If you have transparent knowledge like that, highly public knowledge, then it's much easier to sort of close the loop in terms of accountability, and it becomes a thing that the entire world can work on together.
People love to, you know, just see the numbers, see the impact going on, and if they check in the dashboard monthly and see the numbers rise, it's pretty powerful.
You'll feel like a connection in a way. Every plant that you plant is gonna be here for the next generation.
Local communities are the protectors of the forests, and we want to leave the next generation with a resource and with healthy forests. Everybody should be involved in this.
Go plant a tree. you know, it starts with every one of us.
I tend to have this belief that, like, history is like this rushing river. It has momentum, and you're just like a pebble in this rushing river of mankind's history. But I also believe that the right pebble in the right place can divert the course of a river. So it means that you can be really, really small, but you can be in the right place at the right time. And if you do the right thing, you can change the course of history.